This is our current money pit project car, the Miata. And while we're not done with this thing, I still have plans for it in the future. I was thinking that, you know what they say, variety is the spice of life, and I could use a little spice in my life. So it's time for a whole new project car. We're gonna build a rally car. So we bought a bone stock sedan from the 90s, and we're gonna be modifying it to be our budget DIY off-road rally build, and I'm really excited. Now, sure, you could just take a stock car off-road to some success, but I wanna make this thing way more fun, way more capable, and I wanna make it look pretty cool. So we're gonna be installing and testing a bunch of different rally-inspired mods on our new car, and then we'll figure out whether those mods have been worth all the time, money, and effort that they take to get done. It's gonna be a learning process. One which I'm excited for. Huge thanks to our friends at eBay Motors for sponsoring this new monumental season of Money Pit. Under here lies the new Money Pit, fresh off the internet, and you know there are very few places where you can buy a car and all kinds of parts for it in the same place. And honestly, that's one of the biggest reasons why we've partnered with eBay Motors on this new season of Money Pit. It really has been a challenge to find the right car for this season, and when we said that to eBay Motors, they were like, ah, no problem, baby, we got you. You know, I honestly didn't realize how many options they had listed on the website and how many services they offer to all us buyers to make the car buying experience safe and super easy. It's rad. I just searched through a bunch of cars, finally found the right one, and boom, I can just have it shipped directly to my house just by clicking one single button. The future is wild. And it's pretty affordable to have a car shipped to your house from anywhere in the country. And that saves you the hassle of having to go get it. You gotta go drive it back, tow it back, hop on a plane, and then drive it back, and then your family's mad at you because they don't understand why you're driving through Ohio if not to visit them. You know what I'm talking about. Get the car shipped. eBay Motors even partners with inspection companies around the country, so you can send the car to an inspection site to have it inspected to know exactly what you're getting. Now, I didn't do that because that's kind of a part of the show. We like surprises. But for all you out there looking to get started on a project car, you can use that service and avoid unexpected costs or broken parts. Over the next few months, you're definitely gonna hear us talk about eBay Motors a good amount because we genuinely like working with them. I'm honestly excited about the sponsorship. And without them, we wouldn't even be able to build this car. So click the link in the description, head over to eBay Motors, and now, without further ado, the moment we've all been waiting for. An E36. So today, we're gonna talk about why we even picked this sick E36 for a rally build, and we're gonna give the car an inspection to see if it needs any maintenance before we go sliding it through the desert. Then, we're gonna go out to the desert and put this thing through its paces to see how it does as a stock car. So I am super excited for all this. Now, let's get into the why. Why did I pick an E36 for a rally build? I guess you could say it doesn't really seem to make sense off the top. You might think I'd go for an all-wheel drive car, but I love rear-wheel drive stuff, and E36s are relatively abundant, relatively cheap. They are rear-wheel drive, and I love the way they look. I love everything about them. So all that considered, the real thing that started me down this path of an E36 rally build is there's one short little 15-second clip that just blew me out of the water. Let's take a look at it. So here we go. There's a few different angles of this white BMW just soaring through the air on an off-road rally course. And I mean, he just flies 60, 80, 100 feet easily, sideways, lands in a drift, keeps going. I mean, I'm sure that that chassis was folded like a taco and probably didn't even finish the race. But just watching that boggled my noggin so much that I knew I had to build an E36 rally car. So that brings us to where we are now. And hopefully by the end of this, you'll see me hucking it off a 300-foot jump. Okay, so without further ado, let's actually take a look at our new E36. Here she is. It's a 1998 328i. So that means it's got the M52 straight six in it. And these make decent power. I want to say 190 horsepower at the crank from factory. They got some nice torque and they're very reliable. I think the only real Achilles heel on these things is the cooling system. And I think the cooling system on this one has been replaced. These also have variable valve timing on the intake side. It's called Vanos. Those are known to kind of start going and rattling, but this thing only has 93,000 miles on it. It's so fresh, I can't even believe it. And Vanos is not rattling. And it's a Sierra Rot Red, which is not a super common color, which I am very excited about. Now, I would feel bad about turning this into a rally car because this is such a cool color E36, not that common, but while it is pretty minty fresh, runs great, very well maintained, it's got a lot of dents in pretty much every body panel and a lot of them in really tricky to fix spots. So while it is a cool color, it's kind of banged up, so I don't feel too bad about banging it up further. Now, it's in good shape, apart from the dents, but there is one real problem with this car, in my opinion, for the purpose that we're after. So let me show you the rub. There is one big problem with this car and it's this fat chunk of wood. It's an automatic. And automatics are fine for a daily driver or a weekend car if you like them. They're just fine. But that's not what you really want in a rally car. You want a manual so you can use the clutch and have control over exactly what's going on between your engine and transmission. So you might be wondering why the hell I bought an automatic then? And the answer is money. Automatic E36s are way cheaper than manual E36s. The market has skyrocketed. So it's really hard to find even a clapped out manual E36 for sub $5,000 these days, which is insane. I found this car, which is in pretty minty shape, you'd have to agree, for $4,500. Now, it is automatic, but I'll be able to swap that. And because I bought an automatic, I managed to get a much nicer car for the money. Now, you can see we've got our beautiful sand leather interior here. The headliner is still almost completely up. The door cards are not broken. This is a minty fresh E36. So I think we're gonna have to strip this interior and sell it on eBay, probably. You don't see this stuff very often. All right, so now that we've gotten the introduction out of the way, let's lift this thing up and poke around underneath it. This is the first time I've really gotten eyes on this car, so we gotta give it a little once over and make sure nothing looks like it's broken or about to break, because we're gonna go pretty hard on it. All right, before we go jacking this thing up, let's look under the hood, see what we got going on. Sheesh! Eddie will like that. All right, well, brake fluid looks good. Engine oil looks good. The level is good. We're gonna replace that anyway. Coolant looks good. This whole engine bay looks really good. It's super clean. The engine looks dry and well taken care of. And I don't think we're gonna really have any huge maintenance issues here. Fingers crossed. Now, let's jack it up and see what's going on underneath. Well, boy howdy. This thing is pretty clean. Everything looks really good and really stock under here. I'm pretty pleased. The engine mounts look like they're in good shape. All the bushings look like they're in good shape. Everything seems to be in pretty good order. I really can't fault anything. Everything's dry, there's no leaks. This is awesome. I'm not used to this. The only thing I think that we need to do is an oil change, and then this thing's ready to rip. A lot of BMWs like these use cartridge style filters, which are kind of cool. There's no like metal housing. It's just the filter element itself that goes into a reusable housing on the engine. And when you pop the filter off, you know, this housing is kind of full of oil, and popping the filter out while you still have your drain plug open lets that oil drain down and then out into your drain pan. So it's always a good idea to pop your filter off before you're done draining your oil. Doesn't take too much. It says right on top of it, 25 Newton meters for the torque spec, which is very little. So just get it cinched up and you're good. Now you just gotta throw the drain plug back in, fill this thing full of oil, and head to the desert. All right, now we just need to start this thing up. Then the oil will fill the filter housing. Then we can check the oil level and then we're actually done with maintenance. Moment of truth. What a nice startup. Okay, we're right in the middle of the mark there, which is ideally what you want. A lot of people put it up to full, but the middle's really what the engineers are aiming for. Okay, oil changed, dang. This thing's ready to rip, so let's go rip. We found the desert! Now we just gotta make ourselves a little rally course. I think we found the perfect spot for it. All right, so we're gonna get a short little rally course set up with a few turns, and we're gonna try to test this car in its current state so we can come back to this and do it again and again as we modify the car. So, just up here ahead, I've marked a start line with a burnout in the road, as you do. We'll start here, get going as fast as we can, and then boom, veer off the road onto what looks like something that used to be a road. It's rough, there's a lot of loose asphalt, old loose asphalt, and we'll plow down this as fast as we can go, or as fast as we dare to go. And then we gotta pull a little 180 here at the end, e-brake use optional. And then we're on some tarmac, some actual decent tarmac. Flying back to the street we were just on. As fast as you can. And then back to the intersection with a 90 degree right turn. Some big rocks, ooh, big rock, avoid the big rocks. And then once we make the right hand turn, we're looking for this cone. And once we find the cone, we do a U-turn. 180 degrees to the left here over the berm or the median, and then we're back towards the way we came from. Then we're looking for our second cone, and that it, and there she is for a right hand turn off the road altogether, up a little embankment. Then you got to find your path, plow through. This is completely off road, and then we come back to the road with a hard 180, e-brake optional. Waggle the tail a few times, and then back to the road we started on with a 90 degree right turn, avoiding the big rocks, ideally. Power down, straighten her out, and we're across the line. All right, now that you know the made up course we're gonna run, well, it's time to run it. I'm gonna run 3 laps and I'm gonna go as fast as I can. Then we'll average those times and that'll give us a baseline for how good the stock E36 is at driving off-road in the desert, doing rally stuff. And even though it is bone stock, I gotta tell you, it doesn't feel terrible. It doesn't feel like it hates doing this, which makes me pretty happy. So it's time to put down some times and see what we get.
3, 2, 1, go.
Give it to me straight, Dak.
Straight up. 137.48.
That's the best time I ever ran here.
It is. So that's congratulations.
Thanks, man. All right. Well, I had a few hiccups. I think I could improve on it. So Engine temp is still good. Might as well see what I can do.
3, 2, 1, go!
I know that was better.
Hey, it's like you know what you're doing. 132.9.
5 seconds. Well, 4 seconds. I'll take it. All right, 137 the first time, 132.9 the second time. All right, so if I can improve on that yet again for my third lap, I'll be happy. And honestly, the car feels great. This is super fun. I am glad this is what we chose to do. So I'm gonna go do it again. Was it good?
That was good.
Was it better?
It was better.
I honestly thought it wasn't gonna be, so that's great to hear.
It was close. A little bit of flair at the end.
A little too much flair.
That was for the fans.
A little too much flair. That was for Felipe, yeah.
That was definitely nice though, but still faster, 132.1.
All right, we got a baseline for the freaking E36, and I couldn't be more excited. We've got a cool little racetrack, and honestly, look at this E36, covered in dust. I couldn't be happier. Oh my God. AC's blasting, no check engine lights. Wow, what a thing. I gotta say, the automatic transmission sucks. There's a lot of times where you're putting your foot down and just nothing happens. So I can't wait to fix that. I think that's probably gonna have to be the first thing we fix. You know what I mean? Stick a manual in this thing. Oh boy, 3 pedals, a proper clutch. And I think we could shave a handful of seconds off that time. Guess it's time for a transmission swap. But that's gonna be next week. So until then, make sure you like this video and subscribe to the channel. Go follow me on Instagram at Zach Jobe and follow Donut Media while you're there. And I'll see you guys next Wednesday for a little swappy swap. Goodbye.